Restoration age is known for the genre of prose and the emergence of English novel. When we say the emergence of English novel, we don't mean that the novel actually was seen suddenly. There were certain writings in background and they contributed for the development of a particular genre, that's novel. In background, we can mention Travels of Sir John Mandeville or Thomas Nash, The Unfortunate Traveler, Sir Thomas More, Utopia. These are the writings, and beyond that, there was Spanish influence in Renaissance age that contributed to develop a new genre in English. And in Restoration, that was seen. Usually, English novel, we begin with Daniel Defoe and his novel, Robinson Crusoe. But in modern writings, certain writers have been extracted from the history, and one of them is Ephra Behn. Kal Ephra Behn ka zikr ek dramatist ke taur par kiya tha, The Rover, comedy of action ki baat ki thi. Ephra Behn ne poetry bhi ki, drama bhi likha, novel bhi. She was a prolific writer. And one of her novel that is called Runoko. Runoko is thought one of the earlier novels of English. This novel is thought as a tale of noble African who is carried off to slavery in the English colony of Suriname to illustrate the violence of the slave trade and the corruption of the primitive people. And that corruption is actually committed by treacherous, hypocritical Christian colonizers. That is a novel that celebrates the idea of noble savage. So we can say that's a novel which reflects actually the colonized nation with the ideas of exotic, with the idea of noble savagery. And that novel has been much voiced by feminist and post-colonial authors in 20th century. But in its own time, that novel was ignored, as novelist was not much liked. She was criticized a lot, and it is thought that she spoke out for women's rights, sexual freedom, and that was thought a negative effect on her stature as a writer. There was another writer, Della Rivieri Manley. Della Rivieri Manley also was silenced like Ephra Behn. Manley's novel, The New Atlantis, was a sensational political allegory, and it is compared with Jonathan Swift's work. It is thought that many political figures of the time, they were satirized in that novel. So two earlier novels I have mentioned. One is Runoko by Ephra Behn, and second by Manley, that's The New Atlantis. I move to the more recognized English novelist, and his novel is thought a shift from journalistic feature writing to a novel that's Daniel Defoe, who wrote his work that is called Robinson Crusoe. Daniel Defoe's novels are fundamental to 18th century ways of thinking. These novels range from the quasi-factual A Journal of the Plague Year, an almost journalistic account of London between 1664 and 1665. So A Journal of the Plague Year, that's written, you can say, in a style of early novel, and that's very much close to a book of history or book of journalism. Then he wrote Robinson Crusoe, that's the most enduring fables of Western culture. Robinson Crusoe, everyone who is aware of English literature definitely is aware of that work that is called Robinson Crusoe. That's a story of survival. You can see a survival on an island, survival in a challenging, hostile world. But in modern days, it is also read as a novel of colonizer. Defoe's best known heroine is Moll Flanders, who can titillate readers with her first person narration of a dissolute life as a thief, prostitute, and incestuous wife. So in this way, Daniel Defoe's writings, they were, you can say, rebellious in nature as well. And the heroine of Daniel Defoe's, they were not, like you can say, virtuous domestic wife. Contrary to that, they are, which I have just mentioned, mean they endanger their social reputation, as Moll Flanders appears as thief, prostitute, and incestuous wife. Robinson Crusoe makes a kingdom of the island upon which he is shipwrecked, very like William Shakespeare play The Tempest, where you can say there is Prospero, who is exiled to an island, and he colonizes that island and becomes a master of that island and colonizes Caliban and his mother. So jis tarah Prospero Tempest drama mein hum dekhte hain ki Caliban ke island ko jo hai wo colonize kar leta hai, to yahan par Robinson Crusoe फ्राइडे को जो है वो कॉलोनाइज कर लेता है और इस आइलैंड को जो है पे अपनी अथॉरिटी कायम करता है. क्रूसो इज अ कॉलोनाइजर हु एस्टैब्लिशेस ऑन द आइलैंड अ मॉडल ऑफ हिज ओन सोसाइटी व्हिच विल कंटिन्यू आफ्टर द एंड ऑफ द टेल. रॉबिन्सन्स बिलीफ इन गॉड और इन व्हाट ही हिमसेल्फ इज डूइंग इज नेवर क्वेश्चन. सो we can say that was his sense of superiority, his idea of civilizing the primitive societies that is seen in colonial philosophy. This novel, which has become a potent myth of survival, confirms for the reader the ultimate rightness of Crusoe's way of thinking and acting. The Daniel Defoe ends positively in order not to subvert any of the middle class mercantile values Robinson Crusoe upholds. So Crusoe, having survived 28 years on his first on his desert island, sees his investments make him rich and sees his island colonized without any sympathy for Friday, who was colonized, whom he views as the simple native improved by his master. तो जो कुछ कॉलोनियल मिशन में था कि नेटिव जो हैं उन्हें कोलोनाइज करना है ताकि वो बेहतर इंसान बन सकें, उनके मुआशरे बेहतर बन सकें, वो तहजीब नहीं जानते तो उन्हें तहजीब सिखाई जाए। तो सिविलाइजिंग मिशन, इवन कन्वर्टिंग द नेटिव्स इनटू क्रिश्चियनिटी, जैसे कि अफ्रीका में बहुत ज़्यादा हुआ, इंडिया में थोड़े कम पैमाने पर हुआ, लेकिन इंडिया में भी हम जानते हैं कि जो अनटचेबल थे उनको हम देखते हैं कि उनको जो है क्रिश्चियनाइज किया गया। तो ये वो जो है कॉलोनियल वैल्यूज हैं जो रॉबिन्सन क्रूसो के इस नॉवल में नजर आती हैं, और ये नॉवल सिर्फ बच्चों के लिए एक जैसे एंटरटेनमेंट नॉवल के तौर पर शुरू होता है, ये सिर्फ इतना ही नहीं है बल्कि इसके जो डीपर मीनिंग है वो अभी मैंने आपसे शेयर की। Roxana is another novel of Daniel Defoe. Which subtitle is The Fortunate Mistress. And Roxana, like Moll Flanders, is also, you can say, unsocial female character. Afterwards, Jonathan Swift, Gulliver's Travel has been mentioned, that I introduced yesterday, so I skipped Jonathan Swift, Gulliver's Travel. That is a satire on intrigues of Lilliputians and straightforwardness of Brobdingnagian's institutional tyranny of institutional tyranny of the royal society and conflict of yahoos and hinims and human helplessness to have close resemblance with yahoos. The novels of Daniel Defoe and novels of Ephraim and Manly, they are, you can say, earlier form of novel which are in process. So these novels are more like features. Then we see a form of novel which is introduced by Samuel Richardson. Samuel Richardson is one of the significant novelist of 18th century, known for his epistolary novel. Epistle means letter, and epistolary novel in which letters have been used. Richardson wanted to raise the tone of the novel from the level of this kind of subject matter, and doing so created a heroine for the time. Poor but virtuous Pamela. Pamela is the novel of Samuel Richardson, and Pamela is protagonist of that novel. We can say that's an eponymous novel because the protagonist name is title of the work, title of the novel. Pamela suffers a series of trials at the hands of Mr. B, culminating in attempted rape. She refuses to become his mistress or his wife until she converts Mr. B. We can say Pamela is virtuous. Pamela has a resistance against all temptations and seduction, or you can say our forced rape. And then she converts Mr. B to civilized conduct. In this way, she appears as a woman that is desired by a Puritan society, शी आफ्टर यू कैन से ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ मिस्टर बी शी एग्रीज टू मैरी मिस्टर बी एंड बिकम्स अ पैरागॉन ऑफ वर्च्यू एडमायर्ड बाय ऑल बट शी वाज क्रिटिसाइज्ड एज हिपोक्रिटिकल एंड शी वाज पैरोडीड by Henry Fielding in Sharmila. Sharmila is a novel by Henry Fielding and in Joseph Andrews the character also appears. Sharmila is the sister of Joseph Andrews. And here Henry Fielding actually ridicules Richardson heroine Pamela through his own heroine Sharmila. Pamela was successful in its own days, but later on it was, you can say, criticized, rejected. But in 20th century, again, Richardson's novels are being admired for psychological realism as well as use of letters. And use of letter that can be multiple voices in text instead of a single dominated authorial voice. क्योंकि विक्टोरियन नॉवल में एक वॉइस जो है वो डोमिनेट कर जाती थी, ओमनीसेंट नरेटर होता था, तो उस उन नॉवल्स के लिहाज से तो ये नॉवल जो है वो नहीं अच्छा होगा. लेकिन जो 20th सेंचुरी में नॉवल के ट्रेंड्स आए हैं उसमें दोबारा से रिचर्डसन के नॉवल को अप्रिशिएट किया जा रहा है. रिचर्डसन नेक्स्ट अपिस्टुलरी नॉवल वॉज क्लैरिसा. That marks a major step forward. There are four major letter writers, wherein Pamela almost all the letters come from the heroine alone. तो ये था कि Pamela में एक ही letter था और एक ही writer है जो different letters लिखती है. अगरचे उससे भी different moods तो convey होते हैं, लेकिन जब four letter writers जो हैं वो अपना narrative या अपना perspective बयान करते हैं तो वो ज्यादा राइटर जो है उनको एक वॉइस मिलती. इन क्लैरिसा देयर इज अ सूटर टू क्लैरिसा लवलेस एंड लवलेस प्लेस विद हर इमोशंस इन devious ways, consigning her to a brothel, attempting rape, and leading to the key question, is not this the hour of her trial? Finally, Lovelace drugs and rapes her, and Clarissa not only begins to lose her reason, but also her identity. So that's, you can say, a tragedy of a woman who tries to be poised and chaste. Epistolary novel gives several correspondents the opportunity to set forth a point of view, although one character dominates this multiplicity of viewpoints, creates the impression of diversity leading to consensus. That is the contribution of Richardson के इसमें जो है multiplicity of viewpoints मौजूद है. As I mentioned, he was rejected and he was criticized and even parody of his novels was made by Henry Fielding, the most dominant novel of the time. But in 20th century, Richardson is being reviewed because of his attention to female psychology, female emotions, and use of letters. Henry Fielding, a successful satiric dramatist, yesterday I mentioned his dramas that provoked Sir Robert Walpole, began his novel writing career with Sharmila. That was a pastiche of Pamela. Pastiche is a literary device which means where one novel is left or character a character actually exists in one work and it is expanded and developed in another work. That's a type of intertextuality. Joseph Andrews was his two great novels are Joseph Andrews and Tom Jones. Joseph Andrews was intended as a kind of parody of Richardson, but Fielding found that his novels were taking on a moral life of their own, and he developed his own highly personal narrative style that was humorous, ironic, with an omniscient narrative and destinies, controlling the lives and destinies of his character. So humorous, ironic, and omniscient narrative, these are the features of Richardson novel, Tom Jones and Joseph Andrews. Joseph Andrews is chaste, while Tom Jones is promiscuous. Tom Jones is the model of the young foundling enjoying his freedom to travel, to have relationship, to enjoy sensual experience until his true origins are discovered. When he matures, he assumes his social responsibilities and marries the woman he has always loved, who has, of course, like a medieval crusader's beloved. She has been waiting faithfully for him, so that he was, you can say, a carefree sort of person, very much indulged in sensual life. But after realizing his identity, he reforms himself and he returns to his true beloved. But Joseph Andrew acts otherwise. He is in, you can say, surrounded by different temptations from Lady Booby, Mrs. Slipslop, and Betty in the bar. All these characters try to seduce Joseph. And we know the very name Joseph stands for chastity, because that's for Prophet Joseph, Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam, or kissa Yusuf mein aap padh chuke hain ki kis tarah auratein jo hain wo Hazrat Yusuf par jo hai dore dalti hain. Baki auraton ke saath saath Aziz Misr ki jo biwi hai Zulaikha, wo bhi. Aur Bible se hi notion milta tha ki that's not only the chastity of the woman that is threatened, that is male chastity that is also in danger. So Henry Fielding actually perceived that notion and he used it in this way. He used the title Joseph, Joseph Andrews. So Joseph is the character who has to retain his chastity and save himself from those you can say like Lady Booby or Mrs. Slipslop or Betty or all these women. So chaste Joseph Andrew is contrasted with promiscuous Tom Jones. Richardson has insistence of female virtue, but you can say Henry Fielding has focus on male chastity, male virtue. This no. Fielding's novels are appreciated for three merits. First, that's picaresque novel. Picaresque novel means the protagonists are engaged in antisocial आर फेल्ड एडवेंचर्स, पिकारेस्क एक्चुअली मीन्स रोग, लिटरल मीनिंग इज रोग, एंड बट पिकारेस्क नॉवल वॉज एक्चुअली लाइक अ थ्रिलर इन विच वी सी विलन हीरो टाइप, जैसा फिल्मों में विलन हीरो का एक करेक्टर होता है कि पहले जो है वो कोई पॉकेट मार बना होता है या किसी गैंग का पार्ट होता है या इस तरह का, और फिर जो है वो सडनली उस पर रिवील होता है कि नहीं वो, या उसकी लाइफ में कोई टर्निंग पॉइंट आता है जो उसे बदल के रख देता है और फिर जो है वो एकदम से दूसरी साइड पे आ जाता है। तो ये पिकारेस्क हीरो के जो है वो ट्रेड्स, यही ट्रेड जो है वो स्पेनिश नॉवल्स में होते थे। स्पेनिश नॉवल में पिकारेस्क नॉवल एक डोमिनेंट जॉनरा था, वहां से इंग्लिश में आया तो ये थ्रिलर की सूरत में था। लेकिन जैसे क्लासिक लिटरेचर में जब आप इसको इंक्लूड करते हैं तो इसकी एग्जाम्पल जो है वो हेनरी फील्डिंग के नॉवल्स से लेते हैं कि ये जो करेक्टर्स हैं टॉम जोन्स और जोसेफ एंड्रूस, ये जो है पिकारेस्क नॉवल की एग्जाम्पल है। टॉम जोन्स का तो कह सकते हैं कि क्लियरली एक कंडक्ट भी एंटी सोशल ही रहता है अनलेस ही इज रिवील्ड व्हाट इज हिज ट्रू आइडेंटिटी। लेकिन जोसेफ एंड्रूस का जो बिहेवियर है वो इमोरल नहीं है, लेकिन एंटी सोशल के ही डज नॉट अंडरस्टैंड हिज कंटेम्पररी सोसाइटी एंड ही रिमेन्स एट अ डिस्टेंस एंड ही इज एंगेज्ड इन सर्टन फेल्ड एडवेंचर्स। तो ये फेल्ड एडवेंचर्स जो हैं ये भी पिकारेस्क नॉवल की फीचर है। इसी तरह पिकारेस्क नॉवल जो एपिसोडिक होती है, तो एंटी सोशल, कंडक्ट, फील्ड एडवेंचर्स एंड एपिसोडिक फॉर्म ऑफ नॉवल्स मेक अ नॉवल पिकारेस्क नॉवल। जोसेफ एंड्रयूज एंड टॉम जोन्स आर पिकारेस्क नॉवल। सेकंड ट्रेड इज कॉमिक एपिक इन प्रोज, दैट इज अ लेबल यूज्ड फॉर हिज नॉवल्स दैट दे प्रेजेंट कॉमिक एपिक इन प्रोज। तो हम एपिक जो है उसको डिस्कस किया है पोइट्री में, लेकिन अब जो है वो समझें कि एपिक अपनी इस क्वालिटी की वजह से कि उसमें बहुत ज्यादा डाइग्रेशंस, तो डाइग्रेशंस जो एपिक की क्वालिटी है उसकी वजह से दीज नॉवल्स आर कॉल्ड एपिक एंड दे आर रिटन इन प्रोज, दे आर एपिक इन प्रोज एंड बिकॉज दे आर ह्यूमरस आयरोनिकल दैट्स कॉमिक एपिक इन प्रोज। सो दीज Tom Jones and Joseph Andrews are comic epic in prose. Third quality, that is burlesque comedy, I mentioned that is a label used mostly for, you can say, play in which someone is mocked. So in Fielding novels, because certain characters are mocked or their parody is made, for example Pamela, she is parodied in Shamila and Joseph Andrews. So in this way Shamila and Joseph Andrews, they become burlesque comedy. Some critics believe that Richardson is more forward looking and Fielding more backward looking. ये भी आज के जमाने की बातें हैं, वरना उस जमाने में तो फील्डिंग को ही ज्यादा अप्रिशिएट किया गया था। बट एनी सच जजमेंट इज ओपन टू डिबेट। नॉवल वाज डेवलपिंग अलोंग सेवरल डिफरेंट बट कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री लाइंस, सो रिचर्डसन प्रोवाइड्स मॉडल फॉर द साइकोलॉजिकल नॉवलिस्ट टू फॉलो हिम, फील्डिंग फॉर द सोशल एंड कॉमिक राइटर, बट कैन ऑल्सो सी फील्डिंग फॉर द रियलिस्ट नॉवल्स। तो साइकोलॉजिकल नॉवलिस्ट जो हैं वो उसके लिए रिचर्डसन के मॉडल एक रिचर्डसन के नॉवल्स एक मॉडल प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं, तो फील्डिंग के नॉवल जो हैं वो सोशल सोशल रियलिस्ट नॉवल के लिए एक मॉडल जो है वो प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं। विमेन आल्सो वर राइटिंग एट दैट टाइम, वन एग्जांपल इज अलीजा हेवुड। अलीजा हेवुड शी वॉज एडिटर ऑफ द फीमेल स्पेक्टेटर, जैसे कल बताया था कि रिचर्ड स्टील ने स्पेक्टेटर रिचर्ड स्टील और जोसेफ एडिसन ने मिलकर स्पेक्टेटर शुरू किया था, तो एलिजा हेवर्ड वुड जो है वो फीमेल स्पेक्टेटर नाम से एक मैगजीन चलाती थी, एंड शी आल्सो रोट नॉवेल्स लाइक बेटसी थॉटलेस। सारा फील्डिंग, शी वाज सिस्टर ऑफ हेनरी फील्डिंग, एंड शी आल्सो रोट नॉवल डेविड सिंपल इज टाइटल ऑफ हर एपोनिमस नॉवल। ओलिवर गोल्डस्मिथ, whom I introduced as a dramatist, as poet, he also wrote a novel. His published novel is The Vicar of Wakefield, that was published in 1766. It's a kind of pastoral parable, an improbable fairy tale of a vicar whose family is beset by misfortune. यानी एक क्रिश्चियन वाइकर की कहानी है और उसका खानदान जो है वो जो मिस इकोनॉमिक मिसफॉर्चून है उसके शिकार होता है, और इट रिजेंबल वी कैन से जॉर्ज एलियट सिलास मार्क। देर वॉज अ माइनर नॉवलिस्ट ऑफ माइनर रेपुटेशन, दैट वॉज सैमुअल बटलर। ही रोट अ सेट्रिकल नॉवल हुडिबरस, दैट इज इन फॉर्म ऑफ ए मॉक रोमांस। Then two novelists which were not appreciated in their time, but in contemporary literature they have got much value. First is Laurence Sterne and his novel Tristram Shandy. Laurence Sterne is an Irish English novelist, and he wrote this novel Tristram Shandy that began in 1759 and completed in 1767. That's a novel in 8 volumes. That work was attacked by critics like Johnson, Richardson, Samuel Richardson novelist, and Oliver Goldsmith, but arguably that novel has lasted longer and been more influential than any other novel of its time. Balki 20th century aur ab 21st century mein bahut sare log hain जो ये समझते हैं कि पूरे इंग्लिश लिटरेचर में जो सबसे बेहतरीन नॉवल है वो ट्रिस्टम शैंडी है। दो ऐसे लिटरेरी थ्योरी में स्कूल ऑफ थॉट हैं जो इस नॉवल पे अपनी मतलब के बेस रखते हैं। एक फॉर्मलिस्ट या रशियन फॉर्मलिस्ट स्कूल ऑफ थॉट है, और सिकलोवस्की ने ट्रिस्टम शैंडी को बहुत ज्यादा अप्रिशिएट किया, इसके ऊपर उसका आर्टिकल मौजूद है। उसके बाद जो अपना मेटाफिक्शन है, मेटाफिक्शन ने, और मेटाफिक्शन में ही अगर हम रिलेट करना चाहें तो इंटरटेक्चुअलिटी में भी, तो मेटाफिक्शन में भी इसको बहुत ज्यादा जो है वो वैल्यू किया गया है कि दैट्स नॉवल अबाउट नॉवल। तो इस सेंस में कि ये नॉवल जो है नॉवल के ऊपर, नॉवल राइटिंग की कन्वेंशन पर, प्लॉट पर, करेक्टर और करेक्टराइजेशन पर, नरेटर और नरेशन पर कॉमेंट करता है, इस वजह से ट्रिस्टम शैंडी को बहुत ज्यादा जो है वो हाई रेट किया जा रहा है आज की दुनिया में। अपने जमाने में तो जाहिर है कि जमाना ही सैमुअल जॉनसन का था, तो जॉनसन जो कुछ कह देता था तो लोग उसकी मांग मानते थे। अभी मैं बाद में डिस्कस करता हूँ कि किस वजह से ऐसा होता था। तो जॉनसन वाज अगेंस्ट इट, रिचर्डसन ग्रेट नॉवलिस्ट ऑफ द टाइम, एंड ओलिवर गोल्डस्मिथ वाज नॉवलिस्ट ड्रामेटिस्ट पोएट, they didn't favor that novel. What distinguishes Sterne's writing is its originality and wit. He has been seen as the originator of what came in the 20th century to be known as stream of consciousness. Mean Stern's novel is the beginning or origin of stream of consciousness novel. वो novel जो बाद में James Joyce और Virginia Woolf के जरिए stream of consciousness novel के तौर पर सामने आया, उसकी roots जो है इस novel में तलाश की जाती है. That novel seems first and foremost to parody the developing conventions of the novel as a genre, pointing up the absurdities of that technique, contradiction, impossibilities of relating time, space, reality, and relationship in a linear form. Linear form is ridiculed, but at that time, linear form was the reliable mode of expression. A lot of the novel in the early 18th century followed the natural order of things, beginning, middle, and end. Stern was the first to imply these, not necessarily in that order. He also played with digressions, episodes, going off at a tangent from the main line of the plot. तो प्लॉट के साथ जो उसका एक प्लेफुल एटीट्यूड है राइटर का, उस वजह से ये नॉवल जो है बहुत इसने वैल्यू हासिल की. इसमें कई इन्फ्लुएंसेस भी पॉइंट आउट किए जाते हैं, जिसमें सर जॉन लॉक की जो आइडियाज हैं उसको भी, खासतौर पे एसेज कंसर्निंग ह्यूमन अंडरस्टैंडिंग को समझा जाता है कि उसने स्टर्न को इन्फ्लुएंस किया और स्टर्न के इस वर्क. He also wrote another travelogue. जिस तरह कह लें कि स्टर्न ने नॉवल राइटिंग में एक एक्सपेरिमेंट किया ट्रिस्टम शैंडी से, इसी तरह उसने ट्रेवल राइटिंग में एक एक्सपेरिमेंट किया जो अब काफी वैल्यू किया जाता है, दैट इज अ सेंटिमेंटल जर्नी थ्रू फ्रांस एंड इटली, दैट्स अ ट्रेवलॉग बाय लॉरेंस स्टर्न. आफ्टर लॉरेंस स्टर्न वी सी अ स्कॉटिश नॉवलिस्ट, एंड दैट स्कॉटिश नॉवलिस्ट इज Smollett, and Smollett novel is Humphrey Clinker,